Greetings to the viewers of this video. In this video, we are going to see the fundamental concepts in pharmaceutical rheology. Rheology is the study of the flow and deformation of matter, and it plays a crucial role in various industries, including pharmaceuticals. In the context of pharmaceuticals, rheology is particularly important for understanding the behavior of complex fluids and soft materials used in drug formulation and manufacturing. Here are some fundamental concepts in pharmaceutical rheology. The first one is viscosity. Viscosity is a measure of a fluid's resistance to flow. It determines how easily a fluid can deform or move. Imagine pouring honey and water. Honey flows slowly due to its high viscosity, whereas water flows readily. Viscosity essentially reflects a fluid's internal friction, resisting any applied force that tries to make it flow. Let me explain this with example. In the case of oral suspensions, if the viscosity is too low, the drug particles may settle quickly, making the dosage inconsistent. A higher viscosity ensures uniform suspension. Creams and ointments. A well-controlled viscosity allows for easy application and spreadability while preventing dripping or running. Importance in pharmaceuticals. Controlling viscosity is crucial in the formulation of pharmaceutical products such as oral suspensions, creams, and ointments to ensure proper dosing and administration. Moving on to the next topic, shear stress and shear rate. Shear stress. It is the force applied parallel to a surface per unit area. In rheological terms, it's the force required to make a material flow. Consider the manufacturing of a pharmaceutical ointment. During the mixing process, shear stress is applied to the mixture to ensure uniform dispersion of active ingredients and excipients. The force applied during mixing determines the ointment's consistency and homogeneity. Controlling shear stress is crucial to avoid issues like inadequate mixing or uneven distribution of components. Shear rate. It is the rate at which adjacent layers of a fluid move with respect to each other, indicating the speed of deformation. Think of a liquid pharmaceutical formulation, such as a syrup or suspension. When you pour the liquid from a bottle, the shear rate at the bottle's mouth is high. As the liquid flows down, the shear rate decreases. Understanding shear rate is essential in the design of packaging and dosing systems to ensure that the formulation can flow easily during administration without causing issues like clogging. Let us understand this concept with the help of other examples. Creams and ointments. Shear stress. Applying the cream to the skin is the applied shear stress. A higher stress, stronger rubbing might be needed for thicker creams. Shear rate. This determines how quickly the cream spreads. A well-balanced shear rate allows for easy, even application without dripping or running. Oral suspensions. Shear stress. Shaking the bottle is the applied shear stress, helping disperse the drug particles throughout the liquid. Shear rate. The rate at which the particles move determines how well they stay suspended. Too low shear rate may lead to settling, while too high might affect the stability of the formulation. Transdermal patches. Shear stress. The patch adheres to the skin due to adhesive properties, creating a constant low shear stress. Shear rate. The rate of drug release from the patch can be influenced by the skin's temperature and movement, indirectly modifying the shear rate at the interface. Concept: Newtonian and non-Newtonian behavior. Newtonian fluids. Newtonian fluids have a constant viscosity, regardless of the applied stress or shear rate. The relationship between shear stress, tau, and shear rate, gamma, is linear. Example in pharmaceuticals. Intravenous solutions, such as saline solutions or glucose solutions, are often considered Newtonian fluids. The viscosity remains constant, allowing for predictable flow characteristics during administration through an intravenous line. This is crucial for accurate dosing in medical settings. Non-Newtonian fluids. Non-Newtonian fluids exhibit a variable viscosity, depending on the applied stress or shear rate. The relationship between shear stress and shear rate is non-linear. Types of non-Newtonian fluids. Shear thinning, pseudoplastic. Viscosity decreases with increasing shear rate. Shear thickening, dilatant. Viscosity increases with increasing shear rate. Viscoelastic. Exhibit both elastic and viscous behavior. Examples in pharmaceuticals. Shear thinning, pseudoplastic, example. Many pharmaceutical suspensions, gels, and creams exhibit shear thinning behavior. As an example, consider a topical cream. When applied to the skin, the shear rate is high, leading to decreased viscosity, making it easier to spread. Once applied, the cream regains its higher viscosity, providing better adherence to the skin. Shear thickening, dilatant, example. Some concentrated suspensions, or colloidal systems, may display shear thickening behavior. Imagine a formulation that thickens when subjected to shear forces, such as during stirring or mixing. This behavior is crucial for maintaining the stability and uniformity of the suspension during manufacturing processes. Viscoelastic, example. Biopolymer-based drug delivery systems, like hydrogels, can exhibit viscoelastic behavior. These materials have both elastic properties, they can return to their original shape, and viscous properties, they can flow. This is advantageous for sustained drug release and adherence to biological surfaces. Moving on to the next topic, Thixotropy and Rheopexy. Thixotropy. Some materials exhibit a decrease in viscosity over time under constant stress, e.g., shear thinning behavior. This is called thixotropy. In other words, the material becomes less viscous upon agitation or application of stress, but gradually recovers its original viscosity when the stress is removed. Consider a pharmaceutical gel, such as a topical gel or an oral suspension. When the gel is at rest or not being agitated, it has a higher viscosity, ensuring it stays in place and adheres well to surfaces. However, when the gel is applied, sheared, such as during rubbing onto the skin or pouring from a bottle, its viscosity decreases, making it easier to spread. After application, the gel gradually recovers its higher viscosity, providing sustained adherence to the skin. Rheopexy. In contrast, rheopexy refers to an increase in viscosity over time under constant stress. It refers to the property of materials that exhibit a time-dependent increase in viscosity under constant shear stress, or shear rate. The material becomes more viscous over time when subjected to stress, even if the rate of stress application remains constant. Imagine a pharmaceutical formulation, such as an ointment or cream, that undergoes a change in viscosity when subjected to constant stress. For instance, during the manufacturing process where the formulation experiences continuous stirring, the viscosity may gradually increase over time. This property is beneficial in ensuring the stability of the formulation during processing. Next concept is elasticity and viscoelasticity. Elasticity. The ability of a material to return to its original shape after deformation. Viscoelasticity. Materials that exhibit both viscous, flowing, and elastic, deformable, properties. This is common in polymers and gels used in pharmaceuticals. Going to the next topic, gelation and gel strength, gelation. The process by which a liquid or solid transforms into a gel, a semi-solid material. Gel strength. The ability of a gel to withstand deformation. It is crucial in the formulation of gels and topical products. Rheological measurement techniques. Rheometers. Instruments used to measure the rheological properties of materials. They can provide information on viscosity, shear stress, and other relevant parameters. Temperature and time dependence. Temperature. Rheological properties can be highly dependent on temperature, especially in pharmaceuticals where formulations may experience different temperatures during manufacturing and storage. Time dependence. Some materials exhibit time-dependent behavior, and their rheological properties may change over time. Understanding these fundamental concepts in pharmaceutical rheology is essential for formulators and researchers to design and optimize drug formulations, ensuring the desired physical properties and performance of pharmaceutical products.